Video time. Okay, where do I begin? Well, I'm probably going to be recording this over a couple different time frames in different places, but it basically all started on Memorial Day this year, 2024, sitting in the backyard underneath my orange tree, all by myself, as I frequently do, having a very enjoyable time looking at the garden and the birds and the butterflies and the wasps. And prior to this time of Memorial Day, I've been feeling quite the stirring within me that things need to change. The changes that I'm talking about are ones that have been from my life of being in so much pain, physical body pain, over injuries that I sustained while in the military and such. But during the course of time, I mean, there was a period where for over 10 years, I was on opioids daily, large amounts. And that 10-year time frame came and went. And thankfully, delivered from them, no longer needed them, haven't had them in at least 7 years. Well, during that time, when I made that change, I made the decision to go 100% completely natural, you know, homeopathic, organic, just a complete lifestyle change. And I did that. So when that time came, of course, going natural, and it wasn't hard to figure out what I was going to do for pain management. And also a lot of psychological, mental stuff was going on. Spent multiple years through the VA system with lots of counseling, mental health stuff, you know, learned some things. Mainly learned that I wasn't applying what I learned and still continued being the same way that I was. So in that process of changing and wanting to become as natural and as healthy as I could and get off of the opioids, that process led me right straight into the door of cannabis use, which to this day, I am very thankful I did. And it was daily cannabis use for 7 years, approximately, up until Memorial Day this year. So, and as you know, I mean, I've been a grower. I've grown my own medicine. It's all organic and natural. And I just really wanted to ensure that what I was putting in myself was the best that it could be. Right? We're the Lord's temple. These bodies are not ours, they're His. They belong to Him. So we need to take care of them. And that's what I started doing. So in that 7-year process of cannabis usage and growing, and I don't regret a single second of it. It helped me through. It got me to where I'm at today. It helped me do that transition from the opioids into complete freedom. And that's what I want to talk to you about right now. That's the front story. And so the real story starts just before Memorial Day, sitting out underneath that orange tree. So for months prior to that, just been feeling the unction inside of me and hearing that still small voice, feeling that I just needed to stop. That I needed to stop. So I started that process on that day, on Memorial Day this year. So it was on that day, Memorial Day this year, under the orange tree, that I decided that I had to make this real. And making it real was listening to the Spirit's voice within me, listening to the Holy Spirit, guiding me and directing me to make these changes. And I knew I was going to be successful because when you're following the lead of the Holy Spirit, it's going to be correct. Unlike when you follow your own lead or your own ideas and your own thoughts and what you want to do, most of the times in my life and experience, those moments actually failed and didn't work out too well. So this time I knew I was going to be successful because I had something within sight of me telling me that it was time. And I had that confidence and that faith to know, because I know that voice. I know that still small voice. And I'm very thankful for it. Now that I heard the voice and I had the direction that I needed the plan. And the plan that I had come up with, or the plan that was given to me, I should say, was to start tapering down. And that's what I did. I mean, I was using every day, morning, noon, and night, sun up to sundown. And with that, there comes a tug that you want more, that you need more, that you got to have more. And that's what was happening. So all the modes of delivery that you can think of, taking it in pill form, making my own, you know, growing my own and then putting it in pill form. Of course, there were times of, you know, smoking. There were times of vaping. There were times of dabbing. Pretty much every way that I could get it into my body, I was. But here's the part that a lot of people won't tell you. Yes, cannabis works. It works amazing. It did everything that it was supposed to do for me during that time. But with that came the addiction to it. And I know that generally the message out there is you cannot become addicted to it. Well, you can become addicted to the lifestyle, and that's what I'm talking about. Okay, so don't ever think that it can't grab a hold of you, because it can, and it did to me. There were many times, even prior to the past few months, you know, a couple years ago, where I started hearing, hey, you need to back this off. You need to slow this down. You need to get out of this. But I never listened to that, and I just kept moving forward. But now here I am. And I'm very thankful again for all of it that I had and the road that I went down, and it taught me so much. But I just want you to know, you can become addicted to anything, to any lifestyle, anything that is that's used in your life, especially on a daily basis. The road that I was on to get off of the cannabis, so many times before, trying to stop, just failure one after another. You know, and it would turn into a period of just doing a detox, which, by the way, is a complete separate video that I should make about detoxing from cannabis, because I want you to know it is not fun. for at least 40 days, the side effects and the symptoms that I experienced from coming off of it was horrific. All day long, sweating profusely, just literally dripping, running sweat, night sweats, the shakes, the chills. 1 minute just shaking like it's 30 degrees, and the next minute you're pouring sweat. This went on for 40 days, sweating and cold and low-grade nausea. And the irritability, you talk about cranky pants and irritable, angry, I mean, whatever is in you, it's going to accentuate. So I'm just saying, being addicted to that lifestyle, it's a hard road. I know it looks glamorous and fun on the outside, and it's new, especially these days. Everybody's trying to get it legalized and everywhere, and you know, whatever, go for it. But just be careful. If you need to use it and you want to use it, be careful. Don't let it get a hold of you. You know, because having to have something 24/7 in your life, that's out of balance. That's way out of balance. And so through the addiction of it and the usage of it, I just started feeling lost in it. Didn't want to do it anymore. Like, where's this road taking me? How long am I going to be on this? The rest of my life? Am I going to be growing and using this and doing this for the rest of my life? Those were big questions. Really big questions, because it basically controlled everything about me. I couldn't go anywhere. Well, not me, couldn't. I chose not to go anywhere and do things without using it constantly. You know, and there's a lot of users out there who actually joke about that. You know, you're going to go to the store. You know, you better have something to smoke while you're on your way to the store. But wait, no, you got to have something to smoke before you go to the store. You know, I mean, your mind just continues to throw these thoughts at you that really mislead you. Really mislead you. So that's just a word of caution. You know, you do you. You do what you need to. And make the right choices and make the right decisions. Still haven't got to the story yet. All foundation. So Memorial Day, sitting under the tree, knowing that it was time to quit, I started tapering down. And I did that successfully. Probably a lot quicker than I wanted. I was so wanting this change that I started my taper down really fast. You know, it's like 7 years of use, you know, and you're gonna taper down in a couple days? Nope. I took like 3 weeks of slowly tapering down and still experienced all those symptoms I was talking to you about through the tapering down. And then it even got worse. As soon as the last day came, where the last cannabis went in me, in a cup, like literally one drop in tincture form, one drop was my last one. One drop under my tongue. Or prior to that, it was literally 3 or 4 dropperfuls every time. You know, so we're talking, you know, from coming down from doing doing the highest milligrams that you could do, you know, I just stopped working as well. Just quit working. The effects of it, how I felt, how it made me feel, it went away. And it's like, now I'm taking all this stuff and it's not even working anymore. So that just added to it. And so the taper down was complete. And it was time to start this new life, a new life without having addictions and being pulled to substances. So here comes the story. So I was sitting in my living room, sitting in the chair, just relaxing. And there was that voice again, that still small voice. It wasn't a thought, not a thought. Thoughts come in. No, it was not a thought. It was internal. It was the intuition. The intuition speaking to the thought. That's how it should work. But for most of my life, it's been the other way around, where I let my thoughts run my life instead of listening to the spirit and the intuition running my life. And that's an imbalance, which is also being corrected. So I'm sitting in my chair and I hear that voice. And it literally says, get up and go in the garage. Go to your bin of books. I had a huge tote of books. All my books from previous studies and ministry studies and all of that. And I'm like, okay, let me go do that. So I went out there, went into the garage, and thought I was never going to find this tote. It was deep. There's a lot of them out there, and there's a lot of stuff in the garage. I found the tote. And I'm like, well, here it is. This is amazing. Okay, so I'm like, all right, here it is. I got it. What do you want me to do? And I open it up, again, listening to the voice. And it says, pick up that book right there. And that book was The Spiritual Man by Watchman Nee, which I've read multiple times over the course of the past 20 years. And the voice was so clear. Pick up that book. And I'm like, okay. You got me out of my chair. You got me digging through the garage. By then, I was pouring sweat. It's like 100 degrees in that garage. But I just kept going. And I got it. I got the book. So I go back to my chair. And I just started seeking the Lord, knowing that He was directing each and every step of this. And I'm holding the book. And I opened it, but I didn't open it to page one. I opened it right to the very first page of the chapter called Deliverance. And for the next month, every day, just poring over the pages in this book again and again and again, as I've done before. But before, it was just like for information. Now, it was revelation. And it was so easily understood. Whereas before, it was just reading. Read, 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 and okay, this makes sense. But now there was that the spiritual attachment to it, and it was very real. So I'm sitting there, and I begin reading, and I begin weeping, because the things that I was reading were directly pointed to me. And I was blown away. You know, the mere fact of starting under the orange tree, and now I'm digging through the garage, going through totes, and I get a book, and I get to the point where God has me open this book and takes me right to the section of deliverance. And I knew. I knew it was real. I knew that he was in control, and I knew that what was about to happen was going to be very real and very him. So as I sat reading and weeping, all of a sudden, I knew within, I felt it, I heard it. It was as clear as I'm talking to you right now. The word deliverance. And it hit me like a ton of bricks, and I began sobbing. Just uncontrollable sobbing, because I knew it was real. I knew that God was doing a fantastic work in my life that I was not in control of. I was not in charge of this. I was just following that voice. And this was so real. And as I was weeping and just sitting there, just in that moment, realizing that this was a life-changing moment for me, I just screamed out. I just yelled out. It just came out of me. It's like I didn't think I wanted to do it. I wasn't thinking what to say. I was just sitting there in the rocking chair, and out of my mouth, I just scream as loud as I could the word delivered. Delivered. And I knew that the Lord was doing something incredible in me at that moment. The freedom that I felt, I can't explain. I can't explain it. But it was the peace. You know, it was that peace of God that surpasses all understanding. The kind of peace that we can't figure out. The kind of peace that's like, wow, this feels really amazing. I've never felt like this before. What is this? It's God's peace. And his peace hit me, and I knew that it was going to be okay. I knew that it was his hand that was leading and guiding me on this journey. And so I continued forward with great joy. With great joy and great peace in my life, knowing that this time it's going to stick. This is very, very real. So it was then at that moment where that scripture just came flooding in. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Let me tell you, when God's directing your life through the Holy Spirit, and when he wants to bring deliverance and freedom into your life, he's going to do it. And it's real, and it's going to last. Now, there's another part to this story. It's actually a backstory that goes back over 10 years ago. One that a couple of you know, especially my sister, because it happened when we were at a gathering in the city of Lodi. At a church, and this story within itself is just the most incredible, and I'll share a little bit of that right now. Okay, so the story that happened there, it was actually a woman's conference at this church, a teaching conference. There were probably close to 1,000 people there. A handful of men, myself included, because I went with my sister and brother-in-law. And we were sitting there and we were listening, and the speaker was delivering some words of knowledge and words of wisdom to various people that were seated in the crowd there. So as they continue speaking, I'm sitting there listening, and there's that still small voice again. And it says, I have something to say to you. I'm going to talk to you. And I'm like, okay, I'm sitting there in the chair, you know, the 1,000 people in this building, and I'm hearing this. And the speaker's on stage, and he's talking to various people, telling them things that they need to hear. And I hear the voice again. It says, I'm going to talk to you. Are you ready for this? I'm going to speak. And I'm like, okay, yeah, I guess so. And I'm just sitting there listening. And I hear it again. It says, okay, are you ready? And it's like these words are welling up within me. Are you ready? Here we go. I'm going to speak right now. It was so clear that I literally like grabbed the arms of the chair I was sitting in, like I was holding on, like, okay. And the voice says, okay, here you go. And then at that instant, the speaker from the stage looks at me, pointing at me. I'm probably, I don't know, well over 100 feet away, well, you know, into the, matter of fact, I think I might have even been up in the balcony. I can't recall that part, but I grabbed my arm, the chairs of the, I grabbed the arms of the chair, and he says, here it comes. So the speaker looks at me, and he points at me, and he says, you, sir, right there. Do I know you? And I'm thinking to myself, no. And he says, stand up. So I'm standing up in a room full of people, and he proceeds to deliver a word to me. And I wish I had it with me. I could pull it up and I could read it word for word, because at that point it was all recorded. And thankfully, I got that recording and typed it all up. And the word is quite amazing. It's quite detailed. But the main thing that I want to bring out in that word is he said, are you, you know, as the Holy Spirit said, are you ready? Here it comes. I'm going to talk to you. He stands up and he says, you, sir, I don't know you. Do you know me? And I'm like, no. And he goes on to tell me these wonderful things in my life, things that have happened that he couldn't have known. I didn't know him. He didn't know me. But a couple of the things that he said during that time was that you, sir, are going to be used greatly in a deliverance ministry to set men free from drug addiction, from alcoholism, and from lust. I am going to use you to speak to men to help them change their lives around. This was, again, 10 or 15 years ago that I received this. And so here we are rolled forward to today, and I'm sitting in my rocking chair in the living room getting these words of deliverance, and I'm being delivered, and God's got me in books reading deliverance again, and this word just keeps flooding back into me about how God wants to use me to help other men who are going through what I've went through addiction, through alcohol, and of issues of life, lust in life, wanting and desiring things. And the complete picture is just so amazing. Something that could never be put together by man, because so many people were involved in the process. And every step of the way has just been literally eye-opening and life-changing. And so here I am today, sitting back at the very place where I used to spend many hours doing all of the above. And now I sit here. Oh, now I sit here. The freedom, the peace that I have of walking free from these things sometimes is just overwhelming. And I'm so thankful for it. I'm so thankful for my freedom, my spiritual freedom. I'm just so thankful. I'm so thankful. Because many of those times I was not thankful. And even the word says, you know, that we need to be thankful in all circumstances. Yeah, be thankful. It says, be thankful in all situations, regardless of the circumstances. Now, let me tell you, that's a hard thing. Giving thanks and being grateful for something that you feel is horrifically wrong in your life. That's right. We give thanks to the Creator, to the one who made us. See, we're not thankful for the situation. We're thankful in the situation because we know where our peace lies. We know who and what to focus on, our deliverer. And so I hope this message finds you well. I know it's been a little pieced together and scattered, but I wanted to get out here and get this together in the best way that I can, in hopes that it's going to be seen by the right person who needs to see it. And hopefully they too will find that freedom that only comes through the Son of God, Jesus Christ. That's it. No other way. If you're trying to seek peace in your own methods, in your own ways, you're going to find peace, but it's false peace. It's man-made peace. And it's peace that won't last. So if you want that everlasting peace, you want that everlasting joy, it's found in the Son of God, nowhere else. And that's a fact. Have a blessed day.